To publish and monetize a great news product, you'll likely need to use a suite of technology solutions. These solutions will fulfill various important tasks for you, from the discovery to the delivery to the consumption of your product. Collectively, these are often referred to as your tech stack. But what factors should you consider in building your tech stack? What are the must-have components to launch your product versus the nice-to-haves that can be added later on? I'm Connor Crowley from the Google News Initiative. This video is part of a series to help you build a successful digital news business. Whether you are an aspiring entrepreneur, an emerging startup, or an established print publisher working on your digital transition. Other videos in this series discuss revenue streams, fundraising, building news products, and other ways to strengthen your business, all with the view to becoming financially sustainable. In this video, we will be discussing the tech tools and platforms you need to operate a digital news business. We'll share tool and platform recommendations along the way, as well as some resources that we think will be worth your time. So, let's dig in. Eventually, your tech stack may include dozens of different tools and platforms, but initially, it's important to focus on having at least four main components. These are a content management system, an email service provider, a reader revenue platform, and an analytics tool. If your business will rely on advertising, then you should also consider a customer relationship manager and an advertising platform. Let's take a closer look at these key tech stack components now. A content management system, or CMS for short, is the platform you'll use to build your website and publish your content. There are a number of factors to consider when choosing a CMS. First, how much does it cost? Many popular CMSs, like Ghost and WordPress, offer a free tier, with an option to pay for additional features and capabilities. If you're just starting out, then it's likely that you'll be able to get what you need from a free or low-cost option. As you grow, you can consider availing of a more complex and expensive feature set. Second, unless you have a technical background, you'll want to make sure that the CMS is easy to use. Before making a decision, we recommend testing the product to make sure that you'll be comfortable in managing it. Most providers will offer a demo or a free trial period which you can avail of. You will inevitably encounter an issue or a question when using your new CMS. As you research different providers, be sure to understand the customer service and support resources that you can expect as part of your subscription. Last but not least, it's important to keep in mind what kind of experience the CMS will provide for your users. Here, page load speed and site reliability are two of the key elements to focus on. Which CMS options are available to you will depend on where you are based. I've already mentioned Ghost and WordPress, while other popular providers include Squarespace, Substack, and Newspack, the latter of which is built on WordPress and is specifically for news publishers. The next essential component of your tech stack is an email service provider, or ESP. Among other things, you can use an ESP to send newsletters, run marketing campaigns, and issue donation requests to your audience. So, what should you keep in mind when selecting an ESP? First, consider the goals of your emails. Will you mostly be sending newsletters, membership offers for readers, or donation requests? You should choose your ESP based on how well its strengths match up to how you plan on using it. Next, you'll want to think about the size of your email list, both now and in the medium term. Depending on the ESP, the size of your list will likely impact the price that you'll pay. You should also consider which ESP features are important to you and your news organization. For example, some ESPs allow for unlimited design customization, while others prioritize sending simpler text-based emails. You might want an ESP that can send automated messages after a reader subscribes. Or maybe you'd like an ESP to integrate with other parts of your tech stack. Take time to think through which features are most important to you and your news product. Just as we mentioned with content management systems, you should make sure the platform you're using is user-friendly. See if you can request a demo or a free trial so that you can get a better feel for the ESP. Another good tactic is to reach out to news organizations or associations in your region and ask for their recommendations on a good provider to use. Some popular ESP platforms being used by news organizations include Aweber, Beehive, ConvertKit, and MailChimp. If your business model will even partly be based on reader revenue, we recommend using a platform that will facilitate donations, memberships, or subscriptions. In deciding on which platform to use, you'll need to ask yourself questions like, how much commission will the platform take? Will I have access to my customers' information? What customization does the platform offer to help build relationships? Does it facilitate member-only content or benefits? What's the sign-up experience like for my readers? Will the platform allow me to offer a free trial or freemium content so that potential customers can preview my product before committing? We've seen publishers have success with various platforms, including DonorBox, Memberful, Patreon, Press Patron, and Google's own Reader Revenue Manager. Another key component for any tech stack is an analytics platform. In short, analytics will help you better understand your audience. You can monitor traffic levels and learn about how users are finding and accessing your content, be that on search, through social media, or elsewhere. This information will be valuable as you develop marketing strategies and campaigns and can help you identify which channels are currently most important and which can be improved. You can also use analytics to better understand user behavior. For example, how long does a user spend on your website? What types of articles are they clicking on? How deeply into your podcast are they listening? Analytics will help you answer these questions and ultimately help you to create more of the content your audience is interested in. Popular analytics platforms include Google Analytics, Adobe Analytics, and Parsley. One way to get the most out of your analytics is by using our News Consumer Insights tool, or NCI. NCI gives you personalized, actionable recommendations to help you grow loyalty and revenue based on our automatic analysis of your Google Analytics data. So far, we've talked about the core components any news publisher should have in their tech stack. But there are a few additional features and functions you should consider as well. The first additional feature we recommend is a Customer Relationship Manager, or CRM. If you're just starting out, then a simple spreadsheet might meet your needs initially, but pretty soon, you will likely need a platform to help you manage business leads and coordinate your communication with them. This is especially true if your revenue model is based on advertising, sponsorships, or donations. Options like Streak, Pipedrive, and HiRise are popular among small and mid-sized newsrooms. More advanced advertising-focused publishers may also wish to consider an advertising management platform, such as Google Ad Manager, Broadstreet, or Letterhead. These solutions can often streamline and automate important parts of the advertising process, saving you a lot of time and energy. As your news product grows, your team may find it beneficial to use productivity software, such as Google Workspace, Microsoft Teams, or Slack. These will help you and your team members to stay on the same page and accomplish work collaboratively and remotely. It's true that news publishers also have the option of building their own technology, as opposed to purchasing ready-made solutions like the ones I've mentioned. And although you may have greater control over the features and security of technology that you built yourself, be aware that building typically requires a great deal of expertise, time, and money. So unless you or your team possess deep technical skills, you will be best served by choosing from ready-made solutions. This is especially true if you're just starting on the path to launching your news organization. It may seem overwhelming at first when you're starting to assemble your tech stack. One way to figure out what tech solutions you need and which ones you don't is to consider what problems you have to solve before you can start earning revenue. Ask yourself questions like, how are people going to discover and engage with my content? What's going to get them to sign up for an email newsletter? How can I convince somebody to create an account and buy a subscription? Answering these questions will help you as you navigate the various tech platforms to choose from. And if you're still unsure as to what tech solutions to use, we recommend networking with local or online communities of fellow news entrepreneurs, so that you can ask them what providers they're finding success with. Some great places to start include Lion Publishers' News Entrepreneur Slack channel in North America and Planet Splice in Asia Pacific. That's all for now on building a tech stack, but don't forget to take a look at the other videos in this series to help your business thrive. Also be sure to check out our Startups Labs if you would like to work with a cohort of other new startups in a more in-depth coaching program. More information on that and applications can be found on our website, g.co/news-initiative. If you have any questions or feedback, you can contact us at contactgni@google.com. Thank you and best of luck as you build your tech stack.